So this week on the channel, we're going to take a look at something older than myself and a fair majority of my viewing demographic. This, as you can tell from the writing on the back, is an Italian release Pelican pen. But not just any Pelican. This particular Pelican is the Italian-only released M481. But there's more than meets the eye here, as a quick look at this card in Google Translate show that this particular one is not for resale. So what gives? Well, there are two things that help us narrow down this pen a little. The first is that this finial lacks the iconic Pelican Chick logo and carries the same rounded taper as the piston cap. The second is that this ink window, if the pen wasn't filled with ink right now, is clearly a green-tinted window. Also, this beautiful nib is a giveaway as to the pedigree. It was the limited Italian M481 that came with a 12K gold nib, whereas other M481s at the time came with a gold-plated steel nib like the M200s of today's timeline. This particular one is a hard extra fine. Now, this pen came in four color variants with black green, burgundy, demonstrator, and classic black, but I personally like the look of this black on green. Also, the last point of interest on the pen itself is that the cap band is stamped with the long dissolved West Germany, which I also like as it carries with it a small lesson in the history of post-World War II Europe. One last note, this special release comes with a very well-designed glass bottle of Pelican Königsblau ink. While I'm not writing with it here in this video, keep an eye out for a review of this 30-year-old ink later on the channel. I really like the design and wish Pelican had kept it moving forward. So, now that we've had our history lesson, how does this pen write? Allowing for my biases to kick in for a second, it's amazing. I dread extra fine nibs on every paper, even the Rhodia here, because every EF nib I've ever tried has dug into the paper like I'm digging for gold. This, however, is not the case on this 481. I'm finding it to be extremely smooth on the cross strokes, and it's very forgiving on the upstrokes of the figure eights. Now, with this being an extra fine nib, I also wanted to stack the deck against it, as it were. Pelican 4001 Dark Green is one of the drier inks that I've used in the 4001 series, and I wanted to see if this EF nib could keep the flow going. As you can see on the upside down and right side up that we did here, as well as with my signature that we've got right here, the flow does not fail you with this pen. And going into the regular writing, you can see that I've already grown comfortable with the M481. At the time of filming, I had actually only written one page with this pen, so for it to feel that at home so quickly was something of a miracle. And on Rhodia, I like that the hardness of the nib is perfectly balanced with the smooth feel of gold and iridium gliding across the page. So how does this carry over into Tomoe River? Well, I would describe it as slightly more feedback without crossing the bridge into being overly toothy. I'm definitely getting more feedback on the Tomoe River paper, which I honestly thought would be the other way around, and I'm feeling the nib more on the upstrokes as I write. I'm also finding myself to kind of have to take back the pressure just a little, that way it mimics the overall feel of the Rhodia experience without just completely digging in. I know that sounded hugely negative, but I really don't think it is. Even with the changes I'm having to make to my grip and the pressure on the paper, which are very minor by the way, it doesn't change the end result. You can see that we're still getting the same rate of flow that we saw in the Rhodia, and because we're on Tomoe River, we are getting a little bit more of the dynamics from the 4001 ink. So, for an extra fine, I'm actually officially impressed with it and feel I got a little bit more than I expected on this vintage find. So here's where I try to wrap up everything into a coherent thought. I feel that this is a good, small pen. The 481 was the precursor to the modern 200s, and the look and the feel really do show that. And while I can't stand the smaller feel of like a Sailor Pro Gear Slim, I feel that this pen fits perfectly in my hand. Price is going to be hit or miss though, because the vintage market is a fickle mistress. This find was had for $175, and I feel I paid right in the sweet spot for what it is. Sure, that puts it in the price of a modern 200 with an M400 nib, but the modern version may not have the same story that this one does. A German pen with a one-off Italian variant with a not-for-resale placard and a stamp of a now-defunct country on the cap band? As a history major at uni, that speaks to me. And while I know the previous owner of this pen who sold it to me, who was the Italian that initially was given this gift box? While I will never know the answer to that question, What I do know is that this ended up being a pen that I'm most likely going to keep with me for a long time. And sometimes that's all that matters. But that's it for this video. Ink up that subscribe button, become a patron for early releases and extras, follow the channel on Twitter and Instagram, and remember, don't drink the ink.